Welcome back to another episode of 40 Facts About the 40K Universe. I am your host, Gershwin, and you are watching One Mind Syndicate. Today we continue talking about the Eldar and the Imperium and the Alliance of Convenience as we get into the Coven of Isha. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. We post Warhammer 40K content every single day for you. And if you have any requests, just comment down below. Always check out our archive of lore videos because your request might already be a video and you can watch it now. But with that said, let's get into 40 facts on the Coven of Isha. The Coven of Isha is a secret pact between some members of the Ordo Xenos and the ancient Farseer, Eldred Ulthren of the craft world Ulthway. According to the Coven's librarian, the information provided by the Eldar through this pact has been linked to a number of disastrous events that engulfed the Imperium of Man, including the Sanipan Scouring, the Mortis Annihilation, the Third Coming of Orion, and the First War of Armageddon. The Coven has rarely been invoked, for the Eldar rarely required the help of the Imperium, and the Imperium never looks towards Xenos for help. The most recent time that the Coven was activated was when Death Watch Space Marines from the Ordo Xenos had to help the craft world Ulthway to counter the Dark Eldar's recent raids that took many Ulthway prisoners to Hairsprax, the homeworld of Lilith, the Witch Queen. The prisoners were taken to be slain in the Gladiatrix games. The great Eldar Farseer, Eldred Ulthran, knew that tricks were just for kids, and he created a special Wraithbone chamber hidden aboard the Inquisition's secret space station, located in the Ramugan subsector for the Ordo Xenos, which could be used for communication between the Inquisition and the Seer Council of Ulthway. The Inquisitor Lord Seishon was summoned there to hear the request of Ulthran that the Imperium aid the Eldar in securing Craftworld Ulthway by recovering a lost Eldar relic. The Inquisition's Ramugan space station had stood for millennia and dated back to the time of the Great Crusade, when the Emperor himself was still actively leading the Imperium. The station was home to delegations from three main branches of the Inquisition, the Ordo Xenos, the Ordo Hereticus, and the Ordo Malleus. The Seer Council of Ulthway was convinced to accept aid from the Mongkai, or humans, an action that some members of the council, such as Ruklo, saw as an insult. But the Emerald Seer and the Seer Eldrassen, who had been chosen to serve on the Council of Ulthran, insisted on accepting the humans' aid. At last, the decision was made. A Death Watch kill team departed from Ramugan on the frigate Lance of Darkness by order of the Ordo Xenos to recover the relic for the Eldar and uphold the Coven of Isha. And those were 40 facts on the Coven of Isha. Very short video, but this was a question that came up in one of the episodes of The Greater War. They asked, have the Eldar ever helped the Imperium, and has the Imperium ever helped the Eldar? And of course, the biggest one is the rebirth of Gilliman. But other than that, the Coven of Isha is another really good example of them working together. It rarely happens, because like the story says, Eldar are cocky and the Imperium is xenophobic. So it's rare when this happens, but it does happen. Now, if you guys have any other questions or comments, or really anything that you guys would like to get answered that has the potential to be its own video, so if it's long enough to be a video, just comment down below, and you saw it could be a short, quick answer like this one, or it could be a full-fledged, is the Emperor a demon type of question, which there's already a 40 Facts video for, so check out the 40 Facts on the Emperor being a demon, because he is. And don't scream Inquisition, don't scream heretic, none of that stuff, because you know it's true. But anyways, if you guys have any requests, comment down below. We'll try to get it done for you. And thanks for the support, guys. Thanks for tuning in and listening to us read you the lore. With that said, I'll see you tomorrow. This is Gershwin with One Mind Syndicate, signing out.